Hey guys, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to multiply with decimals. Are you ready? Let's get started. So to start off here, we're going to use a number that's a decimal and a number that's a whole number to multiply together. So the first thing we do is we're going to line them up to the right side. So I'm going to say 1.5 times 2 equals. And you notice I lined up my numbers to the right side, so not by place value. Now we're going to ignore our decimal point for the time being, and we're just going to pretend like we're multiplying as whole numbers. So 2 times 5, that's 10, I carry my 1. 2 times 1, that's 2. I add my carried, that's 3. So now I've done my multiplication as if this is just whole numbers, like 15 times 2. Now what I do is I go back to my decimal point and I count how many total decimal points there are in this problem. So in this one, it's just 1. So I go into my answer, I go to the end, and I move my decimal point the same amount, 1, and I put it there. So I can say 1.5 times 2 is equal to 3.0, which is equal to 3. Is right there. All right, now let's try one where we have both numbers as decimals. So in this one, you'll see we have two decimals that we are multiplying together. 1.6 times 1.9. So let's write them out. I have 1.6 times 1.9 equals. So remember, the first thing I do is I'm going to ignore my decimal points for the time being, and I'm just going to multiply as if these are two whole numbers. So I'm going to start over here with my 9. 9 times 6 is 54. So I put a 4 down there. I carry my 5. 9 times 1 is 9. Plus 5 is 14. Add my 0 here, remember, because I'm moving over to my tens place now, so we're pretending like our decimals aren't there. I'm going to say 1 times 6, that's 6, and 1 times 1, that's a 1. Remember, I add my products together. 4 plus 0 is 4, 6 plus 4 is 10, I carry my 1, 1, 2, and 3. So now I have my whole number as if I was multiplying two whole numbers. But now what I do is I add up my total decimal places for the entire problem. So here I have 1, and here I have another 1. So 1 and 1, that's 2 decimal places that I need to move. So now I go down to my answer, and I'm moving my decimal place 2 places. So there's 1, 2. So my total answer is 3.04. That one right there. Nice work. Let's do one more together to really secure what we've learned. All right, so the final one we're going to do together says 1.1 times 2.3. So let's write it out. 1.1 times 2.3 is equal to. Remember, for the first part here, I'm going to pretend as if I just have whole numbers. I'm going to multiply as I normally would. So 3 times 1 is 3. 3 times 1 again is 3. I'm moving over, so I put my 0 here. 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times 1 is 2. I add my products together. 3 plus 0 is 3. 3 plus 2 is 5. And I bring my 2 down there. Now I add up my decimal points, my decimal places. So I have 1, 2. So I need to move 2 total decimal places over in my answer here. So I put my decimal place at the end, and now I move it over 2 places. 1, 2, decimal point. So my total answer is 2.53. Looks like that one right there. Nice work. So now go ahead and do the online quizzes and play the game to practice what you've learned about multiplying decimals. Have fun and remember to be clever. Hey.